Hello and welcome to Master Market. My name is Grady Arno. I'm an associate director here at Duke's Fuqua School of Business and Admissions, and I'm excited to have with me today Bhupesh from the MQM class of 2019. Bhupesh, how are you?
Good, how are you? Great.
I'm great. Let's start off, Bhupesh, with an introduction from yourself. If you could give us a little bit of information about who you are, that'd be great.
Absolutely. Hey everyone, my name is Bhupesh. I'm the product manager for HC Impact Assessments, which is a product within Gartner. I work with sales on a regular basis, preparing that product. Prior to becoming or moving to the product management job, I was a product consultant. And that job was something that I had gotten right after Fuqua. So it has been like good 4 years since I graduated and have been like growing within Gartner. But yeah, currently I'm based out of Dallas.
That's
That's about
perfect.
it.
So tell me a little bit about your role. What is it that you do on a day-to-day basis?
I like to think of myself as exactly like a bridge between consumers and tech makers or the IT folks. So the idea is like I go and understand from people who want to use a certain software. In my case, it is sales. So it's sales enablement, sales productivity, etc. So I understand the requirements from them and like work with software engineers to get it implemented. Like now, when I say it's a one simple sentence, but it involves a lot of skills that you end up touching on, things like engineering, tech stack, etc. Then there is obviously because of MQM, a lot of analytics comes into picture, and then there's like the business and the communication side of it. So like if I have to put in a simple sentence, like understanding the requirements and communicating it to engineers and helping make create like software which is utilized by the users at the end of the day for like some kind of purpose, or like in this like in my specific case, it is like sales enablement or like sales productivity.
Very cool. So you mentioned before we started this recording that Wednesdays, we're recording this on Wednesday, are a very busy day for you. What does a day look like for you?
Awesome. Yeah. Wednesday is typically a lot busier than the rest of the days because we also have our grooming sessions on a Wednesday. And it's very, I wouldn't say like one day resonates with the other or resembles the other. Every day is like kind of different. But on a typical day, I start my day with my stand up, which is a stand up call with like my engineering team, my design team, data team. Like, so we come together to understand all the tasks that are already there. And we have like 2 week sprints that we release stuff to the software. So like every 2 weeks we have like certain set of requirements that we discuss that we're going to be working on for the next 2 weeks. So it is like a check on like how things are progressing. So that is pretty much very first call that I have with the team. And post that I'll be meeting with other engineers if they have like specific questions. I end up working on understanding like the tech implementations, etc. So that's like my first half. And second half is working with my BI engineer, business intelligence, which I used to do before. But like I have like someone who helps me with it right now. But like to understand how we are progressing with adoption of certain features, our tool, how well we are doing, what is the impact of the usage of the tool, etc. So that is one other aspect that I pretty much touch every day, and that also came with growing within the role that with my senior position, like I got to interact more with the data side, which comes with the background in MQM, and like I utilize a lot of the tools that I learned in the program. I wrap up my day with a lot of customer interviews because that's where I get my requirements from. So interacting with the customers, interacting with the leadership of sales, etc. Like that's where I get the hot topics that are like needed by the industry or by the team that we need to like be thinking about like putting in the roadmap, etc. So it starts with the engineering team or the implementation. Goes on to the data side of things, and then eventually understanding from the users and the customers what they should like and what I should be working on, etc.
That certainly sounds like a busy day. And you're managing a lot of different priorities within each of those meetings that you're having throughout the day. So, what are some tools or some things that you've used to manage your priorities throughout the day or throughout your role?
Absolutely. So, I think like framework is like more of like the essence here. tools, like pretty much all the tools have like that framework built in it. Like if you think of Notion or like monday.com, like all of them have some kind of tool inbuilt to help you with the prioritization. And you'll hear that from pretty much every product manager, but prioritization is like key, because that's where you end up prioritizing certain features that need to go first or get implemented first. But it's like a little data driven, and like how, so there are certain parameters that you look for. For example, if I'm like thinking of a feature, I'll think of like, what is the reach of the feature? Is it going to be impacting 1,000 people? Is it going to be impacting like 10,000 people? So all of a sudden, like higher the reach, the more prioritized it is going to be. And there are other parameters just like that. Like what is the impact going to be? Is the impact going to help in like crazy retention? Yeah, that obviously we have to like dig deeper, but if it is going to impact that, we're definitely going to be prioritizing that before. So there are like certain parameters that we like look for whenever these features kind of come in. From like early on, as soon as it becomes a requirement, we are looking at all of these features, parameters, and then like there's a final score that comes out of it. And then like once we have like a good final score that is, you know, kind of surpasses the other ones, it's like a simple sort and we know what to work on. But said that, that is a framework that we use, but there are sometimes, you know, there are certain requirements that are more needy than the others that we like, you know, and which is like a leadership focus or something like that. And you can imagine like with Gen AI, like a lot of things get prioritized without necessarily having those parameters like fulfilled. But yeah, that's typically how we end up prioritizing.
Yeah, that sounds very typical for an MQM student to mention using data to make something a priority, which is really exciting. And going off of that, you mentioned at the beginning that since you graduated in 2019, you've been working at Gartner. What made you decide that Gartner was the best choice for you? And what was your plans going into the MQM program?
No, absolutely. That's a great question. Funny enough, like my role at Gartner was also like I got through like a Fuqua alumni. So there was a Gartner session within with the career panel, and he came in. He was working on a pilot program within Gartner for a client product consulting role. And I knew that I wanted to work in product in like some capacity. At the time, I was looking for product analyst roles or like anything in the vicinity around product. And when that role came up, I connected with him and eventually got the opportunity to interview with them. And like it was like a very good fit of like what I want to do around product. And the role involved me interacting with product managers and product marketing managers. They were supposed to be my clients. And then at the same time, the idea was to provide them value or understand their issues and like, provide them value through Gartner license. So it was like, you know, consuming a lot of Gartner research and like providing value to or like helping them prioritize or helping them with priorities that they're working on, which kind of gave me a gist of what product managers do on a day-to-day life. And I'm like, this is exciting. I want to do something similar as I progress into the role. And then eventually after one and a half years, after being in the product consulting role, I eventually moved to the product management side. And even there, like Gartner was very supportive. My manager back then was really inclined towards me trying to pursue a career in product management, made some introductions, and then eventually I interviewed within the company and I got a product manager role. Yeah.
That's fantastic. It's always great to see upward mobility within one company. So tell me about, this is your third role, correct, within Gartner? Right. How have your goals changed with each role, and what have you learned about yourself and moved up as you moved up the organization?
That's a great question again. So in terms of like to start with, like when I was in my very first role when I started Gartner, the goal was very straightforward. It's like providing value to the clients, and that involved understanding and it's a very cliche thing to say, but like listening was not necessarily like something that I thought was like a skill, but it became like a good skill, like working in that role where you listen to them, you ask very informed questions, you dive deeper into what they were doing. So the idea was like you were asking or listening, you're asking very, very good questions and listening primarily to drive one single goal, was providing them value through the Gartner license and through their entire interaction that they have with you. Because these are product executives who don't necessarily have a lot of time. So they want, like, if you are getting in a call with them, you want to make sure that they're getting like good benefit from the entire interaction. That translated into my other roles as well. Like once I gained the skills, the goal for the new role that I took, which was a product manager, was to make it easy for the customers to utilize the product. And the impact or like the end goal of the product is also that we want to retain more customers. So the goal has kind of remained the same throughout, to be honest with you, in spite of the roles being different, was to make sure that the users are getting like a lot of value. Back then they were like Gartner clients. Now they are like sales or like account executives, which use the product or the tool that I work on to share data-driven automated like presentations with the client, which is like more informed. And if you see like one thing that has been like common throughout is while I'm helping them with the goal, data has been at the center of pretty much everything that I do. So, and that's where like MKM kind of comes into picture. So, and even with the new role that I took, so with the senior product manager role that I got, one thing that I started, the growth opportunity was tied to the data aspects of things that I could look for. So we work, this was a nascent product that I started working on in 2021. Post like the initial adoption, we built you know, a lot of reporting, a lot of analytics behind it. So this, the new role that I like took up involved building those reporting and analytics features behind the product, which given the fact that it was a new product, like we needed to build all those things as we progress. And that's what the new role entails. But yeah.
Yeah, that's fantastic. Is there anything that you really learned about yourself that you may not have known when you got into Gartner that you've learned as you've advanced?
Yeah, I would like to, like, I still think the same, but I always thought like I wouldn't necessarily enjoy like meeting with people on calls and or the interactions. But if, like being in the client facing role in my very first role, like post Fuqua, it just opened me to like the idea of interacting or like asking questions or, you know, meeting someone who have you never met before. And I continue to do that. Like there are so many users that I meet on a day-to-day basis who I haven't like met before, and understanding their issues and like getting into like their day-to-day and using all of that information to, you know, create like some feature for the tool, et cetera. So, like as I mentioned earlier, like listening is such a skill. Like, communication is definitely ties into communication. But in my role, even previously and even now, like one skill that like pays off like really well is like listening and like asking good questions. Just goes a long way. But yeah,
absolutely, that's fantastic. What is the culture like at Gartner, and how does it compare to any roles that you may have had previous?
Fortunately, I've always had like good leadership and good managers to like work with. With Gartner specifically, I would say that it's a very open culture, like, and that's exactly why like I've been able to like move up and around the company as well. One thing that has always been is like I'm able to speak about like my goals and like my IDP and like things like that. My last role, the role previous to that, these are all the things that I've reached out or like wanted to like do, and fortunately I've gotten like that space and time to like do like work on it, and which is like what one can like wish for. So they've been like very encouraging in terms of taking up like new responsibilities and like translating all of that into a role that fits their needs and as well as mine. But yeah,
that's great. What do your future goals look like?
Yeah, this is a great question. So like, since I just started the new role in April, I wanted to make sure that, and there's like a lot of building with the new role. But when I say building, like apart from the product, there's like a lot of data reporting analytics that I'm building for the product. But at the same time, eventually, like when it comes to like a good place, I want to be, I want to like move into like the product leader kind of position where like, you know, looking for other portfolios of products or even like is some kind of other leadership where eventually like I'm there's the big questions that they ask. And this is also like stems from like the very first role when I used to like meet with product leaders, the way they were thinking, the way they were thinking about the bottom line, as well as how in line they were with all the you know, features, the market, etc. So that was something that I took from my previous role and I continue to think about it. So eventually when I grow in this role, I want to like look for like product leadership positions, and that might like look very different as I grew into the role, because honestly, it has always been very dynamic of things I like, things I want to do, and things I want to learn, etc. But yeah.
Yeah, that's fantastic to hear. Last question for you is, what's one piece of advice you'd give to someone that is either interested in entering Gartner or the MQM program?
Absolutely. So one thing would be like, get to know more about like how, like I'm still using the course material, and it, like just know like what you don't have necessarily have to like pick and choose what you want to learn, but at the same time, you won't be retaining like 100% of it. So like pick and choose like the tools that you want to be using. And I continue to use those in my day-to-day basis. Like, so one of the best courses that I took at like MQM was CRM, but before even like thinking about like taking CRM, I didn't know I'd be using it on my, in my regular job. So take that, like before making the choice about like your tracks, your program, etc., like get into the course, ask more questions about the courses. And the same thing about the role, like the amount of questions that I've asked about each role that I got into, it involves like not just like the day to day, but like projects, your projects that you're going to be working on, impact you're going to be having. So what would growth look like? That is like, these are typical questions, but also really essential for making a decision to like pursue a course or pursue like a job. But asking questions, and
That is perfect advice. Thank you so much, Bhupesh. It was great to see you and talk to you and hear so much about what you're being able to do at Gartner, and that you've been able to do so much since graduating from the MQM program. It's clear that you're a master in the market, and we look forward to seeing how you grow over the next few years.
Thank you so much, Grady. I appreciate it. Thanks for calling.